guys. Got something real special for y'all today. Got somebody very special to introduce to you here. This here is Papa T in his 41 GMC pickup truck. And we're going to be pinstriping it today. Going to be putting some lines down, front, back, side, maybe a little bit on the inside. But before we got started, just wanted to hand it over to him and let him tell you a little bit about the truck, because this thing's pretty interesting.
Thank you, Seth. Welcome to my neighborhood. Excited to see a little something special go on this rusty old rat rod. It is a 41, very rare 41 GMC pickup. Williams Custom Shop did a wonderful job installing the 350 and transmission. Has a 9-inch Ford rear end and a Mustang 2 front end. And it just freaking screams. And the pinstripe's going to make it another 10 more horsepower, I think, going down the road. So I'm excited. Looking forward to having some of your art on the project. Right.
But we're going to get started on this thing. We're going to clean it up a little bit in the spots we're going to be working on. And going to throw down some lines.
Have at it.
With this black, I'm laying down this black layer first, and it's going to be some simpler stuff. It's not going to be too busy, because the second color, the red, that's what's going to accent off of the black. So just going to lay down some basic little puzzle pieces, and then the rest of the red will take care of everything else. Come back here. He had mentioned something up here doing. But I can't really think in my head of a good way to make those body lines work with something there. Plus this and this is gonna be on top of each other. I think what I'm gonna do is go put a little something on each headlight. But then it looks pretty cool if I could do something where it's dragging forward off of both sides going this way. So got done with the black, just the first layer, like I said, just wanted to make a good base layer to run off of the red. The whole time I used this Black Widow is Widow 1. It's perfect for the size we were working with and the area we were working with, because I could still get thin enough lines, but then run into some fat lines if I wanted to. Anything fatter probably would have been a little too much, but it's perfect enough to jump off the truck at you a little bit, but still be in the shadows with the black and being a little bit thinner lines. But from here, we got a little something on the hood here. Both lights have this here. And we can go around the other side. You can probably see it here better. Got a little something on the hood right here. It plays off of these latches. And don't know if you see it, it's kind of in the shadows here with the black, but there is a little something around the door handle. You can peek inside there. We got just a little something to work off of the glove box there. On either side of the bed, measured it out, found the center, and just did some pieces here on both sides. And to wrap up the back on the tailgate, found the center with the license plate. And just did a little something there. Nothing too crazy, since he's got his stickers and the license plate. Just wanted to add a little something. Now, I'm gonna take the same size brush, just change up the paint. Gonna add some red accents, and that should be it on this thing.
Nice.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna add some little ones over here. Just to make it pop off here. Okay. I like that. I don't know what those are called, but I really love doing them because it just kind of looks like a, not a cat's tail, but like the end of either weeds or just some type of plant. And it's real easy with these scroll brushes to do some like plant type looking things. See my hand jump?
Yeah.
On my autograph a little bit in dating, but got you on the front here. Of course, you saw the lights before. Uh-huh. Did a little bit on the side, and the door handles here. But I think one of my favorite parts is the glove box because it's different from anything else on the truck. And of course, you saw it come out.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I touched it up a little bit.
That's cool, but I know that I'm riding down the road trying to loose my load. I got pinstripes on my mind.
You did it. Seth did this. Yeah. It's awesome.
And then, I don't know, this kind of reminds me of like surfer stuff. I don't know why. It just kind of looks like that kind of travel surfer thing.
Yeah. I'll have to get my surfboard out and wax it up. It's awesome.
To wrap up the end, just a little something. It's so hard when you got like just a flat surface where you could, it was wide open like this. I mean, I could go from there to there just filling this whole thing up. But I think that, with how little it is, I think that would be just fine right there.
That's
just like that.
Yeah, you did an awesome job.
It's tempting.
The rat.